one word.
Don't all shout it from anyone. Any word.
Balcony.
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 When I think about it, I think about Romeo and Juliet. I think about any kind of theater production in which like there are multiple levels and somebody's calling out one to the other. And in ninth grade at my high school, there you go, right here, put on Beauty and the Beast. And I was cast as a plate, which it was not exactly where I had dreamed I would land, but only one freshman even got close to a main role. And she was just the understudy, and she was very upset. And anyways, they built like a big set for us on stage, and during Be Our Guest, all the plates and cutlery and whatever had to dance across this like very high platform above everybody else, singing Be Our Guest. I don't think we were mic'd, you know, just like putting a little noise out into the world. It was very fun. That's about the amazing
All right, so you two are auditioning for Flatware in Beauty and the Beast.
Preferably, I would like to shake things up, and I'd like to be a spook.
Okay.
I thought this was Belle. I thought this was the lead.
Not you, honey. No. Let me introduce myself. Tabitha Simmons. I'm directing this production, and we're kind of re-envisioning this story, and it's actually the story of the objects in the castle. Okay, Belle is a side character. It's about the objects and their relationship to each other.
So if Belle was the principal, it wouldn't be you.
All right.
It's weird that I do my hair like this, but it's fine.
Well, so look, let me share with you, this is an exceptionally physical production. I come from an interpretive dance background, and so I really want to see kind of what you can bring to these roles from a physical perspective. So what's your name again?
I was going to say Tabitha, that's your name. It is my name, but I can't.
You cannot have the same name. The modern day spoken word only Swan Lake.
You were one of the 20 people who saw.
Yeah, so what I'd like to see now is you as Spork. I love it. It's daring, it's visionary, okay? And you know, Betsy, I called you in because I thought that, you know, your work as an usher in that production was captivating. And I'd really like to see how you interact. Could you please try and chip the teacup, and I'll go ahead and interrupt you as needed. Go ahead.
I'm a fork and a spoon. I am truly a mystery.
This is brilliant. This is brilliant. Let me just stop you there. Could you see if you could communicate the sporkiness with no words at all? Just as three times. Of course. That's all right. Go ahead. Whenever you're ready.
Wait, what's my motivation?
You know, you have a deep and forbidden attraction to this cup. It can never be realized, but I want to see it in your eyes.
Quick question, sure. This is adaptation. Mm-hmm. Is Chip an adult now?
Yes. Oh, Chip,
we're smoking it out. okay, listen. I talked to your dad. He told me that he's sad he didn't get the part of Hannibal. Yeah. But that's absolutely no reason to keep smoking. I get it. Hannibal is edgy, right?
No. Hannibal's not edgy.
Oh.
I'm too edgy for Hannibal, that's why I didn't get the part.
That's okay. Okay. This is where we are now. Could you hand me the wrench over there, please? Thank you. So, too edgy for him.
Yeah, you know, community theaters doesn't get me. I mean, Mom, I really think I might be bound for the big time. That might be the only place where my talents are appreciated.
So, as an 11th grader,
yeah,
who smokes,
yeah,
you're gonna hop community theater and go directly to Broadway? Is that what I understand?
I was thinking more of the screen.
Oh, yeah. Could you I'll make it a Phillips screwdriver. So the screen, huh? You're gonna move to old Hollywood.
Yeah, Mom. I just... I would come alive on screen. Imagine this. Close up on my face. Cigarette dangling. Tear streaming down my cheek. Because my lady left me. Oscar.
That's...
I'm getting an Oscar for that.
Okay, 11th grade, skip community theater, skip Broadway, go to screen, get an Oscar.
You raised me to believe in myself, and I do.
Jeffrey, I don't know how to tell you this, but your dreams, these dreams, they're ridiculous. They're unachievable. Could you hand me a flathead screwdriver?
No, Mom. You told me for 16 years I could be president if I wanted to. I don't want to be president. I want to be the next Marlon Brando. A lot easier than president. There's only one of those.
There's only one of
presidents. At a time.
There's only one Marlon Brando at a time as well. His name is Marlon Brando. There's just one of them.
Mom, he's dead, okay? They need an inheritor. I'm sorry, but I'm thinking about dropping out and just getting on a bus. My friend Stu lives in LA. I can stay with him.
Do that. It's fine. It's fine. Leave your life. Leave your family. Go be with Stu. When you win that Oscar, I tell you what. Don't you dare thank me.
Mom.
Joe?
We don't have a cafeteria! Yeah, I mean, do you think we have time?
falcon and the space needle. You don't want to misstep.
This is really high.
We do not need a review of what happened at the CN Tower.
Yep.
That was shit.
Yep.
That was my brother.
Can we just specify in more detail what exactly happened at the CN Tower?
Do you not remember? You have completely lost all memory.
That was really traumatic, I think.
Yes, it was!
I knew we should never handle the reunion in Canada. Just saying.
So, what we did was we went out of the CN Tower and got really, really close to the edge. And this one thought it was funny and started joking around. And jokes led.
I don't want to stand by him anymore! I don't want to stand by him!
Just a little horseplay!
Come back here! This is the most dramatic moment of my life. You are so casually recapping it.
Did he?
Rochelle?
Did he die?
Yes!
Tabitha was your Christian name.
I know.
I gave it to you based on your grandmother.
I know, Mother.
And you discarded it for what? A career on the stage?
Yes. It's just, I also discarded my accent. I'm so sorry. You need a classic accent when you go onto the stage, Mother. I'm so sorry, Mother, but the director was named Tabitha, and she said there was no way that there could be two Tabithas, so I had to be Lily.
Lily, you said?
Lily is Lily now, professionally.
You went by Lily?
Yes, I'm in SAG-AFTRA as Lily.
You named yourself after this little old Wisconsin housewife?
Yes. We both have this accent.
I moved here from the coast.
Mark Jeffrey Jane.
tangent. And it's David O. Russell. I mean, this is a dream part. You know, I felt like in many ways I raised myself. I never had a parental figure until you, David. And whatever talent, you know, I was blessed with in this life certainly came not from the environment in which I was raised. You know, I think it could be accurately described as a hellhole. And I drew on that trauma to play this part in L4.
When you come back to the Gulf Coast. Yeah, come on in, Alma.
Oh my god, no. Hi, I'm from Twitter. And we just saw your son's acceptance speech, and we just had to interview you. All of Twitter wants to know, he basically credited you and your shitty parenting for all that he achieved. How does that feel?
I told him when he won this Oscar, if he won this Oscar, he better not thank me for anything. And that includes a shitty raising. So I do not appreciate it. And you can tell him that.
Why, all of Twitter just did. That's how Twitter works. So do you have any other words for him that you'd like to impart?
For him, I'm giving no words. It seems like if I give him good words, he might succeed. If I give him bad words, he might succeed. And the one thing I don't want, Mark, Jeffrey, Samuels, whatever he is, I don't want him to succeed. Okay. So, bye.
Okay.
Sweetheart, it's me. I'm dying. You probably know that because you're by my hospital bedside. And I just have to say, raise our son shittily, because I have a feeling it will make him do great things. But you really have to commit to the bit. You have to be real shitty, like forever. You can't go back. That's the only way he'll succeed. Are you increasing the
Canada? Are you Canadian spy? Canadian spy, Canadian spy!
No. Hey, we have a lot of classified documents here in this Florida hotel room, okay? We cannot have him in here.
You're four, you can't see these things.
Oh, so this one is relative to Five Eyes, so you could see this one.
I'm sorry for my other friends. They're being a little xenophobic about me. But you are welcome here in this Florida hotel.
It's on your head. What's your real name? Say pussy in the way that you're saying it. Okay?
Wait, so I just wanna